What's up everyone, Xula's here, and I've got some more building tips for you. This one is how to build smoother ramps so that you don't get hung up with the motorcycles or the lower cars. So first off, here's the two ramps. This one on the left is the newer one, and this one on the right is the sort of jagged one. It actually looks kind of better, but it's not. So here's the difference. As you can see, the bottoms of the ramps go over each other, and on this one the top of the ramp overlaps so you don't hit it when you go up it. So that's the difference in both the ramps, and I'm going to go ahead and show real quick me driving on them so you can see the difference when you jump on them. Test real quick. Got Michael here. Drive out here. Jump this thing. And very smooth. Just flew right over it. Love it. Got to rebuild all my ramps. And of course a big shout out to Unspoken Ouch and Azula, who was the first one to do this, I believe. And there's been many, many more. And let's do the jagged one now. We're approaching it. Let's see what happens when we hit it. Oh. Yeah, so that's, you know what I mean, that's what happened a lot of times on the motorcycle. So this new building technique, you won't have that problem. Okay, so let's go ahead and build this thing. I'll get a bunch of small ramps here. We're going to build the ramp real quick. So I used the chevron sign and just the punch technique to get them on there. If you don't know how to do this, then check some of my other videos. And let's go ahead and build this real quick. So you want to stack four of them. It's always the last one that gives you a problem, right? Yeah, we'll get it on there. So there's that. So we got all four of them. So now you want to go ahead and pull the third one out. And then get on an angle like this. Then go ahead and get it maybe right about there. And you can use the electrical box for this one. Or you can use a sign too. Let's use electrical box. There it is. And that would probably work, but you know what? I'm gonna just do it one more time, just to get it right on the edge. So we need to back it up just a little bit, probably right about there. Yeah, that should be perfect. Let's go ahead and put it there. There it was. Yeah, so there it's underneath. You can see the lip goes underneath the other one. That's what we want, so we don't catch on it. So go ahead and pick up number two. That was the second ramp you put down, and then go ahead and get an angle like this and do the same thing basically. Get that right about there. Yeah, it's perfect. You line it up right on the second beam. Yes, and that's what we want. Yep, that's about perfect. And then we'll grab the bottom one. Can't pick it up. Oh, this thing's being difficult. Okay, delete that. There we go. Alright, I think it's just easier to do this angle for me because I can see the back of it, but you could just do it the front way too. Yeah, probably about right there. I'm moving up just a little bit. Alright. So that is exactly what we wanted. Yeah, that's the new smooth improved ramp. Once again, shout out to Unspoken Ouch and Azula. They were the first ones to find this. I'm gonna go ahead and drive over here and jump it real quick. Test it out, make sure it's smooth. Oh yeah, smooth as a baby's bottom, you just jump right off from it. Nice. Yeah, I like that saying, because my bottom, I'm not a baby, and it's not smooth. So anyways, if you enjoyed this video, hey, that's awesome. And I got a lot more tips and stuff, so check back, see what I got for you. And let me do some loops real quick. Yeah, all right. Well, anyways, peace out, Exulas.